Welcome, welcome, everyone. This is Mike Riley from MikeRileyNow.com and the USAPodcast.com. I'm here with the Grassroots Democrats HQ in Los Angeles. See, I got my hat on today, representing. And I'm here to talk to everyone today about the Fellows program that the Grassroots Democrats HQ has going on. And we're here talking to one of the Grassroots Democrats HQ's most renowned fellows, Mr. Eric Wagner. Is it Eric Wagner or Wagner?
Wagner.
Wagner, okay, yeah.
In the old days, I guess.
Yeah, yeah, those are like the back in the old country, yeah. Very cool. Well, thanks for joining me, Eric, man. Good to see you here on this morning. So, so we've been talking to a few people about the Fellows program and about how it works and about how people got inspired to get into it. You know, give us a little backdrop. How did you get inspired? What got you interested in becoming a fellow for the Grassroots Democrats HQ?
I guess I've always been pretty interested in politics. Like throughout high school, I would always make an effort to learn more about it, to keep up with it, have discussions with people in my school, even if we disagreed a lot about it. Mm-hmm. And I recognized how important 2020 was. Kind of given COVID, summer was a little tough to figure stuff out. And I saw an opportunity with the Grassroots Democrats HQ, and I thought it would be a great way to both learn, since I may be interested in politics in the future, and also have a direct impact on the 2020 election.
Absolutely. And speaking of having a direct impact on the 2020 election, do you feel like your role in the Grassroots Democrats HQ as a fellow is allowing you to do that?
I definitely think it is. I've been helping a lot, set up a lot of phone banks, which has been very cool, a good way to reach out to voters in the most direct form now, given COVID, since we can't really canvass.
Mm-hmm.
Helping make sure people have enough postcards so they can write voters in swing states. And then has also been helping out when Grassroots Democrats sets up like a fundraiser or a gala. I've been able to help out with that. So I've definitely been feeling like I've been making a direct impact and also just learning more about what it takes to be an organizer.
Absolutely, man. That's a good skill set to have. Mm-hmm. So let me ask you this, like, you know, when you're setting up these phone banks and helping people out, you know, going through the postcards and things like that, what's the training process like? So like, say for instance, I joined the Grassroots Democrats HQ and I want to be a volunteer. You know, I go on grassrootsdems.org, which is something that you can do too. But I go there and I sign up to volunteer. How would Eric train me to be ready to go out there and usher in this blue tsunami for 2020?
Yeah, the training isn't too bad usually. It usually just takes, I'd say if you're tech savvy, it's certainly a lot easier. Yeah. Just because a lot of it is kind of working the software, but really after that, it's just kind of going through scripts and making sure you understand what the goal is. A lot of it is just trying to make sure people are personable, friendly, be themselves, try and engage in conversations and be open for any questions and answers. So mm-hmm. I think it really could only take 5 to 10 minutes, honestly, and be very short. And then once you learn it once, you can do it again for the rest of your life. So
right. Yeah, teach a man how to fish, or however that saying goes. Yeah. Yeah. Do you ever run into... what do you do if you run into, you know, some friction, somebody who disagrees with you or a Trump supporter?
That's honestly tough. Sometimes you kind of have to read the situation. Sometimes it may be worth talking more. Like if someone's maybe not sure about an issue or doesn't really understand, it's definitely good to talk to them, try and help them understand issues better. And then, because usually I like to think that Democrats are on the right side of the issue. So if you just educate people, mm-hmm. they're willing to see what the right side is. But then there are always some cases where it's just a headstrong person who's going to say Trump no matter what.
Mm-hmm.
At that point, it may not be worth your time debating with them while you can be dialing up more numbers and convincing more people to vote.
Absolutely. So
you can read the situation.
Absolutely. Well, you sound like you're a good teacher there, Eric. You sound like you trained very well.
Thank you.
Yeah, man. You could be like a what do they call those, like sensei or a guru in the art of training people how to phone bank and get ready for the blue wave.
My title, phone bank sensei.
Yeah, phone bank sensei. That'd be dope. Absolutely. Well, Eric, thank you so much. And you out there, before we get out of here, I just want to let you know that you too could be just like Eric here. Or you can get trained by Eric and learn how to be just like Eric. All you got to do is go to grassrootsdems.org and sign up to be a volunteer. You can phone bank, you can canvass, or do the virtual canvassing, as we call it these days. Or you can go ahead and write postcards or write letters or do anything you can to be a part of the blue wave coming up, or as I call it, the blue tsunami in 2020. Thank you so much, Eric. I am Michael Riley from MikeRileyNow.com. Thank you so much, and we'll see y'all soon.